In the eyes of many adventurers, merchants, and even mercenaries, Aru Village is the only safe haven in an otherwise treacherous desert. Though far from prosperous, it provides ample food and water to all who come here in need, as well as a bed for the night. On one condition, do not disturb the peace.
Stay close.
As the sworn protector of Aru Village, Candace is highly adept with her shield and spear, with the aid of her hydrovision. She can fend off the strongest of storms and the fiercest of foes. Life is harsh in the hot and arid desert. Strength and endurance are the key to survival for those who dwell here. When Candace is in the party, the active character benefits from reduced stamina consumption from climbing. Candace's normal attack can combo up to 4 strikes with her polearm, dealing physical damage. Using her charged attack, Candace consumes a certain amount of stamina to lunge forward, dealing physical damage to enemies along the way. Tap Candace's elemental skill to perform a swift shield strike, dealing hydro damage to enemies in front. Hold her elemental skill, and she raises the shield to block attacks from nearby enemies. The shield absorbs damage based on her max HP and offers extra protection against hydro damage. The shield can remain until Candace finishes casting her elemental skill. After holding the skill for a fixed duration, Candace will finish charging her attack. Then, when the skill is released, its duration expires or the shield is broken, she performs a forward leaping strike that deals hydro damage. After unlocking the talent Aegis of Crossed Arrows, if Candace is hit while holding her elemental skill, she instantly finishes charging.
We shall prevail!
When Candace unleashes her elemental burst, she holds her weapon high to summon Divine Assistance, which deals AoE hydro damage based on her max HP, and continuously grants the Prayer of the Crimson Crown state to the active character. In this state, when a character's normal attack deals elemental damage to an enemy, the damage dealt is increased. Switching characters unleashes a rippling wave attack, dealing hydro damage to nearby enemies. This can only be triggered a limited number of times during Prayer of the Crimson Crown's duration. Additionally, characters wielding a sword, claymore, or polearm gain a hydro infusion while Prayer of the Crimson Crown is in effect. After unlocking the talent Celestial Dome of Sand, when a character under the effect of Prayer of the Crimson Crown deals elemental damage with a normal attack, damage dealt is increased based on Candace's max HP. Candace is a kind soul who is only too happy to stow her weapon when not needed, but anyone who mistakes her good nature for weakness and fails to respect the customs of Aru Village should prepare to face the consequences. When battle commences, Candace comes to the defense of the party, using her elemental skill to block the enemy's attack and perform a counterattack. When energy is full, she casts her elemental burst to deal AoE hydro damage and boost her teammates' normal attacks with the Prayer of the Crimson Crown status, then joins them in removing the unruly visitors from Aru Village for good. There are many rumors about the village guardian with the one golden eye. They say that the sands are her spies, the storm winds are her servants, the blood of King Deshret flows in her veins, and that even the strongest of foes must yield at her command. People who have lost their guardian deity often display the greatest interest in the gods, but having never seen a god with their own eyes, the far-fetched products of their naive imaginations are poor substitutes for reality. Yet despite being the subject of these fanciful rumors, Candace herself takes a much more sober view of things. A shield is but a tool, a polearm but a weapon, and what matters most is not the divine power a weapon contains, but the determination of the one who wields it.